Leviathan, the legendary creature that hunted megalodons. When first described, Leviathan was actually named Leviathan after the biblical sea monster. Unfortunately, however, Leviathan had already been used to name a mastodon, now known as mammut. Leviathan is actually a synonym to this genus, but still cannot be used. As such, the Hebrew word for Leviathan, Leviathan, is now used to refer to this ancient whale. The species name, L. melvillei, is in honor of the author Herman Melville, the man who wrote the world-famous novel Moby Dick. Because only the skull is known, Leviathan is often compared to the sperm whale when piecing together the rest of the body. This has yielded size estimates of 44.3 feet, 13.5 meters, and weighed around 50 tons, or about 100,000 pounds, which makes Leviathan a comparable size to the megatoothed sharks. However, Leviathan has also been compared to another prehistoric whale named Zygophyceta, and this resulted in an estimate of 17.5 meters. If accurate, then this would make Leviathan comparable to even Megalodon, the largest shark to ever swim the ocean. In fact, for a time, both Leviathan and Sea Megalodon would have swam in the same oceans. Today's sperm whale has no functional teeth in its upper jaw, and only small ones in its lower jaw, which are mostly used in fights. It feeds through suction, relying on a rush of water to carry its prey into its open mouth. But Leviathan's mouth was full of huge teeth, the largest of which were a foot long and around 4 inches wide, 10 centimeters. This was no suction feeder. Leviathan clearly grabbed its prey with a powerful bite, inflicting deep wounds and tearing off flesh as killer whales do, but with a skull 3 times bigger. Not only was Leviathan an apex predator like Sea Megalodon, it probably fed upon the same prey animals, which were medium-sized baleen whales. Smaller, juvenile Leviathan may have preferred proportionally smaller prey items like the smaller cetaceans or even large fish. With teeth that were 14 inches, 36 centimeters long, Leviathan had the dentition to take down large prey items. In fact, not only were the teeth of Leviathan considerably larger than Sea Megalodon teeth, they are considered to be the largest known teeth for the purpose of eating. How Leviathan hunted is still a matter of debate, but given its large mouth and teeth, it may have used a similar method to kill smaller whales as Sea Megalodon did. This could be approaching from the bottom and slamming into its target from underneath. An associated method could also be trapping the smaller whale's ribcage in its jaws and crushing the ribs to create fatal injuries to the internal organs. Another method could see Leviathan holding down a whale beneath the surface to stop it surfacing for air. This is a strategy that would potentially be risky for Leviathan, as it too would still need to surface to breathe air. But assuming Leviathan could hold its breath for longer than its prey, it would still be a viable strategy. Leviathan is morphologically similar to the modern sperm whale, and this has brought comparisons between the two for head function. Leviathan is thought to have had a spermaceti organ that would have been filled with wax and oil. This has also inferred the possibility that Leviathan may have used echolocation to find its prey. The sperm whale might use its spermaceti organ for control buoyancy during a dive by pumping in cold water, solidifying the wax and increasing the density of its head. At the depths, the energy expended during a hunt heats up the wax and melts it again. But Leviathan probably didn't hunt for squid and probably wasn't a deep diver like the modern sperm whale. In light of this, other explanations become more intriguing. The case containing the spermaceti could be used as a battering ram during fights. It could also boost the sperm whale's echolocation, allowing it to stun its prey with sound, or woo females. The male's organ is particularly big. It's perhaps no coincidence that the biggest shark in history, the mighty Megalodon, also appeared at the same time, in the same part of the world. It, too, was thought to have hunted whales, and many of its teeth have also been found at Cerro Colorado. For the moment, it's hard to say if the two predators were direct competitors, since they may have swum in different parts of the Peruvian seas. Lambert speculates that the adults of either species could have eaten the young of the other, but there's no evidence for this yet. What do you think would happen if the great Leviathan fought a megalodon? The prehistoric whale's teeth were even longer and thicker than those of megalodon. Second, as a warm-blooded mammal, Leviathan presumably possessed a bigger brain than any plus-sized sharks or fish in its habitat, and thus would have been quicker to react in close-quarter, fin-to-fin combat. But imagine a great white shark scaled up by a factor of 10, and you'll get some idea what a fearsome killing machine Megalodon was. By some calculations, Megalodon wielded the most powerful bite, somewhere between 11 and 18 tons of force per square inch, of any animal that ever lived. And it had an unusual talent for shearing off its prey's tough, cartilaginous fins, then zooming in for the kill once its adversary had been rendered immobile in the water. Megalodon was more of an ambush predator and wouldn't really know what to do in a head-on match, unlike a sperm whale, which is used to defending itself. So, Leviathan would win this. Also, keep in mind that whales hunt in pods, and a gang of them would absolutely butcher Megalodon. Leviathan had larger teeth, and they would bite deeper than Megalodon. And keep in mind that they had echolocation. So, like a modern sperm whale that stuns a giant squid with a loud sonic boom, they could probably stun a shark in the same way, as sharks, as a general rule, have sensitive hearing. Additionally, Leviathan could use its head as a battering ram to render prey unconscious, and that would do serious damage if it hit a megalodon in the gills. And don't forget that Leviathan had a much, much larger brain than Megalodon's primitive shark brain. Thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button.